But keeping it real, you know, you start getting aches and pains in your body and things start, you know, going haywire on you. Like I told y'all, this damn eye, I thought this eye was going to fall out of my head. I ain't playing with y'all. And y'all ain't even checked up on me to see if my damn eyeball is still working. Y'all don't love me. Y'all don't care.
You're just smiling.
Okay, guys, it's Monday, and guess what? Wendy is back. Who else thought that Wendy wasn't coming back? I thought that hussy was going to be somewhere in old Calabasas rehab, recovering from whatever it was that she was on that got her there. I mean, I'm just going to be honest with you, right? And I have made it known that Wendy, you know, the Williams, has not been my most favorite person. I mean, Wendy Williams has rubbed a lot of people the wrong way. But I wouldn't be who I was or who I am if I said that I was not happy that she returned. What I'm going to do is we're going to do a couple of clips from Hot Topic where Wendy Williams discussed her mental and physical health and her situation with Kevin. So let's get into it.
Thank you. I miss you too. Look, honestly, I didn't know what to expect when I hit the block today. I didn't know whether you would wait for me, whether you would understand. I had no idea what to expect. Thank you so much for waiting for us. Thank you. But you know, I'm not exactly a hypochondriac, but I might be a hyper. You know what I mean? You know, all this time you've been watching this show, you know I love doctors, I respect the medical community, I also love homeopathic medicines. I'm always up in my doctors' faces, like, what's this? Ow. You know? So what happened was, we were supposed to only be off for 2 weeks for Christmas vacation. And towards the end of the 2 weeks, I started to feel thyroidish. Well, they're still adjusting my meds, and if you don't know about thyroid disease, it's a lifetime thing, and they're always adjusting and always doing stuff, and it can really screw you over. And so they're adjusting my thyroid meds, and then the eyeballs attached to the thyroid, which is my Graves disease, and then you know, I always have the equilibrium thing with my vertigo and a million other things. And I'm the kind of patient, if I cough, I'm thinking I'm dying. I know I've gotten to that point. I love the doc. I can't even tell you how many doctors I have, but I want to shout out to each and every one of you. Thank you so much. They push me in there, I get the MRIs, and then I get the CAT scans, and then they get me running on the treadmill, and they're doing my blood pressure at the same time as my phone is calling with people from the show, you know, calling and asking me stuff. I'm like, my blood pressure's not high. Wow. And then the salt levels, and you know, I'm 54, and not for nothing, even though you feel 25, honey, you know. You're still your age on the inside, so I have a plethora.
Even though, you know, I know Wendy Williams has gotten some work done on her face, her body, wherever. She does look good for her age. Now, she looked like she's had some work done, but when she said that, okay, regardless of what a person looks like, they still feel who they are on the inside, because keeping it real, I'm 48, I look younger. That might be a lot of reason why people think they can come at me sideways, because they don't know that I'm old enough to be their mama.
Not a big thing for, you know, Kevin and Kevin to come with me to doctor's appointments. We all go to each, do you go to the doctors with your family? Mm-hmm. Like, I go, it's not, you know, because of the panic mode, you just go because you go. It's, you know, you wanna know, because sometimes a family member will hide something from you and you need to know. You know, so I'm the type, you know, I will go in the room with the doctor when Kevin or in the other room, to one of their doctors and say, okay, what's the real deal? You know, and they'll tell. So, you know, but so we're spending time as a family, the Hunters, you know, I'm Wendy Hunter. We're spending time as a family, and I just wanted to take some time for myself. Now, you know, I am my own best friend. You know that. I've told you that forever.
So, hold it, Clarence. Did Wendy the Williams do a Julie Chen move as on us? Did she just say, you know, the Hunters, because I am Wendy Hunter. Let me move on.
But outside, yeah, when you get into yourself, you're your own best friend. And so I'm at home, and I'm taking my thyroid meds, and I'm meditating. Oh, believe me you. I'm going to the gym 7 days a week for 2 hours a day. Believe me you. I don't know how this outfit is reading on TV, but mother has not gained a pound. But you have to take care of yourself. And one of the things that really does suck about our country is that we don't have proper medical care. And I know that many people watching, many people in the audience, I know you don't have to raise your hands for it or clap. But I know many of you, even if you have health insurance, you don't go to the doctors. And if you do, if you don't have health insurance, I'm sorry.
I want to shout out to my husband. I'm still wearing my ring. Well, believe me, you, when you've been with somebody for 28 years, married for 25 years, then we date. When we got married, we waited like 4 years before doing the baby project and stuff. So we know each other. He's my best friend, he's my lover, he's all this and he's all that. I know what you've been seeing, and I knew what the streets have been talking about. But, hunty, let me show you who I fell in love with and who he fell in love with. Him. In love with my husband, and anybody who's been married for 5 minutes or 500 years, you know, marriages have ebbs and flows, marriages are not easy, and don't ask me about mine until you see this born, and it ain't going anywhere.
So let's just go over right quick my thoughts of the return of Wendy Williams. Now, let me start right here. I'm not going to bash her for wanting to stay with her husband. I have never bashed any woman for deciding to stay and fight for her relationship. However, if the relationship is abusive, I do have a problem with that because you should not be involving children in your abuse. You know, because I've seen a lot in my age. I told you I was in the criminal justice field a long time. Some people's relationship function easily with abuse. My problem is just don't expose the children to it. Unfortunately, what I believe is that Lil Kev has experienced some of the abuse here and there, but they have enough money where it's, they can like hide it. You know, like what Bobby and Whitney did on one side of the house, you know, they was over there getting it on. And on the other side was Bobby Christina and the nanny. So I kind of believe that that is a possibility of what happened with Lil' Kev. And it's weird to me and strange to me how those women are in the audience like clapping like, yes, Wendy, yes. I'm like, nobody's looking around and going, wait a minute. Y'all know Kevin was... What the world? Am I the only one who knows what happened? Y'all gonna clap for her? Maybe they're clapping for her return, but when are the people in the audience going to be like, wait a minute, girl. Wait a minute, girl. Because she called herself mother on today's show. Now, wait a minute, girl. You can't be a mother because you need to be a leader, a trendsetter, you know, a force to be reckoned with. I'm going to tell you that part of your credibility has been taken from you because you've decided to stay in a relationship that is an openly cheating relationship. You know, we only hear about Kev. We don't hear about you, Wendy DeWilliams Hunter. Okay, because what I need you to do now, just go ahead and Julie Chen it out and just go ahead and say, you know, Wendy Williams Hunter. This Julie Chen move as it out. Stop faking. Go ahead. Just be like, I'm in it to win it. And like I said, I'm not mad at her. It's just the people in the audience. I'm looking at them like, why are you pretending like, you know, nothing's wrong? Something is wrong. The next thing I want to say about it is, the way that Wendy Williams came off on the show was more so like, I'm staying with my man. There was no sense of vulnerability, no sense of weakness. Like, what I expected for her to do was to tell her truth in a vulnerable place. But because she came back and it was still like, I'm sticking with my man. I don't care what you huzzies say about me. You know, it did not. Now, don't get me wrong. You know, I fight for the underdog. I do, you know. But Wendy is not the underdog in this one. Wait a minute. And as far as the ring thing, no, hussy. Don't put my ring on, you know. With that segment where it was at the show where they was like displaying jewelry plates when you take your ring off and you put it on a plate. Child, I got an old jewelry box that's been passed down for years from my grandmother. But some people put their jewelry on a jewelry plate. The young lady put her jewelry, Wendy Williams put her favorite piece of jewelry down on the jewelry plate. The young lady picked it up and put it on. Not my goddamn ring, girl. You will never put my ring on, because Wendy snatched that thing up and was like, oh girl, wait a minute, don't soil my ring with your bad relationships vibes. Are you in a bad relationship? She was like, no, I'm in a good relationship. Okay girl, but you know we don't want no hot vagina hussy soiling our ring. Me, because I feel, do not put my ring on. I don't care if you in a great relationship, an amazing relationship, a rich relationship, I don't care. Nobody is doing or done the things that I done to get that daggone ring. And that's all I had to say about that. Am I the only petty mother sucker that's like, no, you ain't got these ring privileges? No, don't put my goddamn ring on. Because when people, women be like, oh, Nay, your ring is beautiful, let me put it on. Ho. Never. Ho. You will never put my ring on. Because you ain't do the things that I did to get the damn ring. I know I didn't say that like 1,000 times, but I mean it. Don't forget to look out for my Queen Supreme Court review and my American Soul review. And don't forget to watch my Leaving Neverland recap and discussion. Now, remember this, the same people you meet on the way up will always be the same people that you meet on the way down. Naysayers, my patron loves. House of Nayrob, if you need me, I am always here. Let's be good to each other. Deuce.